Hi, this is Julieta Yang Orfiano. Welcome to my video. If this is your first time on my channel, please like, share, and subscribe so I can notify you if I have a new video. This is the continuation of part 18 about property, land, and equipment. I discuss in part 18 about depreciation of assets used in mining activities. Just click above or the link below this video to watch part 18. In this video, I am going to tackle about exploration for and evaluation of mineral resources. Exploration for and evaluation of mineral resources. Enterprises engaged in extractive industry incur exploration and evaluation expenditures. Exploration and evaluation expenditures are those incurred by an entity in connection with the exploration for and evaluation of mineral resources before the technical feasibility and commercial viability of extracting a mineral resource are demonstrable. Appendix A, PFRS number 6, Exploration for and Evaluation of Mineral Resources. PFRS or IFRS number 6 addresses the financial reporting for the exploration and evaluation of mineral resources, including minerals, oil, natural gas, and similar non-regenerative resources. Until now, there are different views on how exploration and evaluation expenditures should be accounted for. In accordance with accounting standards, the IAS board decided to develop an accounting standard that addresses the reporting needs of enterprises in the extractive activities. PFRS or IFRS number 6 provides limited and initial guidance about the accounting for extractive activities. In formulating accounting policy on the treatment of exploration and evaluation expenditures, two conventional methods are considered by extractive companies: the successful efforts method and the full cost method. Under the successful efforts method, costs that results to successful discovery and acquisition of mineral resources are capitalized and amortized, while costs of unsuccessful acquisition and exploration activities are recorded as expenses. Under the full cost method, all costs incurred in acquisition and exploration of mineral resources are capitalized and amortized. PFRS or IFRS number 6 does not specify a specific principle on the accounting for exploration and evaluation expenditures. The standard allows an entity to determine a policy specifying which expenditures are recognized as exploration and evaluation assets. Such policy shall be applied consistently. If the entity makes a policy of recognizing the exploration and evaluation expenditures as assets, the assets shall be recognized initially at cost. The following are examples of expenditures that might be included in exploration and evaluation assets. Par number 9, PFRS or IFRS number 6. First, acquisition of rights to explore. Second, topographical, geographical, geochemical, and geophysical studies. Number 3, exploratory drilling. Fourth, trenching. Fifth, sampling. And number 6, activities in relation to evaluating the technical feasibility and commercial viability of extracting a mineral resource. Expenditures related to the development of mineral resources, such as cost of building roads and tunnels, and items of property, plant, and equipment used to develop and maintain exploration and evaluation assets shall not form part of exploration and evaluation assets. In the statement of financial position, the exploration and evaluation assets shall be classified either as property, plant, and equipment, or intangible assets, based in the nature of the asset. Exploration and evaluation assets shall be carried on the statement of financial position using either the cost model or the revaluation model, based on the accounting policy for the class of assets. Similar to property, plant, and equipment, and intangible assets, exploration and evaluation assets are to be assessed for impairment when facts and circumstances suggest that the carrying amount of the asset exceeds its recoverable amount. Facts and circumstances that may suggest that the exploration and evaluation assets are impaired include the following: PAR number 20, PFRS or IFRS number 6. First, the period for which the entity has the right to explore in the specific area is expired during the period or will expire in the near future and is not expected to be renewed. Second, substantive expenditure on further exploration for and evaluation of mineral resources in the specific area is neither budgeted nor planned. Number 3, exploration for and evaluation of mineral resources in the specific area have not led to the discovery of commercially viable quantities of mineral resources and the entity has decided to discontinue such activities in the specific area. And number 4, sufficient data exists to indicate that although development in the specific area is likely to proceed, the carrying amount of the exploration and evaluation asset is unlikely to be recovered in full from successful development or by sale. Any impairment loss is recognized as an expense. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you learned something from this video. I did part 20 and continuation of this video wherein I discuss in part 20 about the expenditures after initial recognition. Just click above or the link below this video to watch part 20. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe on my channel so I can notify you if I have a new video. Once again, this is Julieta Yang Orfiano. See you on my next video.